Today we are going to learn the difference in the IPA between the as in good sound and the oo as in two sound. Hey everybody, what's up? It's Christina from English with Christina, and welcome back to another American English pronunciation lesson. If you haven't already done so, then go ahead and click on that little subscribe button down below and the bell that lets you know when a new English lesson becomes available, because I do upload weekly English lessons, so you definitely want to be sure not to miss those. In today's lesson, we're going to talk about the difference between the as in good sound and the oo as in two sound. I've gotten a lot of questions and those wonderful comments that you all leave me in the videos here below asking for more IPA and pronunciation videos. So let's jump right into it. And stay tuned, because at the end of the video, we're going to do a fun tongue twister to see how well you can pronounce these two sounds when they're close together and how fast you can pronounce them. So the as in good sound is very often confused with the oo sound, because many times, especially in the word good, for instance, is spelled with two O's. But before we get into all the spellings, let's talk about how we effectively make this sound first. Now, to make the sound, our lips are going to be semi-relaxed. They're going to be only slightly rounded, just a very little bit. You will feel a little bit of push on the muscles of the lips pushing outward, but just a little bit. It's ever so slight. And the tongue is going to be relaxed, but the back part of the tongue is going to be higher up in the mouth. So the tip of your tongue, right here, will be behind your lower front teeth. But then the back part gradually raises up. Now, let's practice with the word good. 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 Very good. Some common spelling patterns for the as in good sounds are two O's, such as the word good, or book, or look. Another common spelling pattern is O-U-L-D, as in would, or could, or should. And another common spelling pattern for this sound is going to be a U, such as in the word push. So when we want to tell somebody how we just read a really good book, we're going to use that sound in both the words good and book. I hear a lot of my students, both adults and children alike, trying to say good or book. And this is not how we pronounce these words in English. Your lips want to be more relaxed than that oo sound, which we're going to get to in just a moment. But for the time being, suffice it to say that we're going to use the as in good sound. Good book. Hey, I just read a really good book. Another expression we could use here is took a look. Took is the past tense form of take, so instead of saying take a look as an order or in the present tense, if we want to say it in the past tense, we could say I took a look. So for example, I took a look out the window and you wouldn't believe what I saw. Took a look. Try practicing this question here. Could you help me look for my book? Could you help me look for my book? Could you help me look for my book? Now let's move on to the oo as in two sound, very commonly confused with many words that actually use the as in good sound. So first of all, how do we make this sound? The oo as in two sound is made by basically turning our lips into a circle, ooh, ooh, forming a tight circle with our lips. So our lips are going to be tense, as if we're trying to blow out a candle. But instead of breathing out the way we would if we were blowing out a candle, use your voice. Ooh, ooh. So instead of where you don't feel any vibration right here, use your voice. Ooh. Ooh. You do feel a vibration when you use your voice. This is a really good way to practice that ooh sound. As for your tongue is going to be only slightly tense and it's going to be a little bit higher in the mouth. Ooh, ooh, ooh. The tip of the tongue can be in the middle or down behind the lower front teeth, but the rest of your tongue is going to be kind of in a mid-high position there. Ooh, ooh. Two. Let's take a look at some common spelling patterns for this sound. The first common spelling pattern for this sound is going to be the double O. Just like how we've talked about with good, just to confuse you a little bit more, we also have a very common spelling pattern for the double O to make the oo sound, as in two, as in I like it too, me too. Another common word with this spelling pattern is food. School. You get the idea. The next common spelling pattern is a U-E to make this sound ooh, such as the word true. Blue is also another very common word that we use on a regular basis that has a U-E together and makes the ooh sound. Another common spelling pattern for this ooh sound is just a simple O, such as do or who. The next spelling pattern for this sound could be an EW sound, such as the word new. That could be NEW or KNEW, as they both sound exactly the same, or flu or blew. I blew out the candle. Finally, the last common spelling pattern for this sound is a U, such as the word super or rule. Let's take a look at some word pairs, shall we? If we say the words too few, are we using the oo sound or are we using the uh sound? We're using the oo sound. Too with the double O and few with the EW. Or how about blue shoes? Blue has the UE spelling pattern and also makes the oo sound, and shoes has an O, technically OE, but it also makes that oo sound. Let's try some word contrasts, shall we? Listen carefully. Pull, pool, look, Luke, full, fool, stood, stewed. Now let's try a bit of a tongue twister to see how well you're able to distinguish and differentiate these two sounds, as well as produce these sounds when they're very close together. The full fool looked at Luke and tried to pull the pool. The full fool looked at Luke and tried to pull the pool. If that becomes easy for you, then as we should do with all tongue twisters, just try to say it a little bit faster and see how fast you can get. The full fool looked at Luke and tried to pull the pool. The full fool looked at Luke and tried to pull the pool. It can get a little exhausting. I had to actually visualize those words as I was saying them to you, so it can definitely get a little bit exhausting even for native speakers. Now, I'm curious, if you guys try to say this 5 times fast, if you can say it correctly and confidently, how fast can you say it? What's your time when you try to say it 5 times fast? Let me know in the comments below. If there are any other IPA symbols or words you would like me to help you pronounce, then go ahead and leave a comment for me and let me know below so that I can make a video and share it with you and you can share with someone else who might need a little bit of extra help as well. Because that's what this is supposed to be, right? Sharing is caring. All right, everybody, so that concludes our lesson today on the uh as in good and the ooh as in too sound. You guys did absolutely wonderful. Stay tuned for next week's English lesson, and I will see you next time. Mwah. Bye, guys. Whoops. It's between. Not in. Some comments. Oh my goodness.